This is the second straight season the Bills' interior studs Kyle Williams and Marcell Dareus have failed to play a whole season together. Williams only played 350 snaps in 2015, while Dareus has only logged 310 snaps this season. That is a lot of production lost and a lot of game planning that doesn't have to take place when both are not in the lineup. So far in 2016, when they are active, they are productive. Both are amongst the best versus the run in the NFL. Having both of them in the lineup this week should help a Buffalo defense that has struggled without them. Versus Pittsburgh in Week 14, Williams missed his first game this season. To no avail, Buffalo surrendered 236 yards to Le'Veon Bell alone. The Steelers were able to run a lot of gap concepts at Buffalo's defensive ends. Without the technique of the savvy Williams to drop his knee and anchor down versus double teams, the Steelers dominated in the trenches. In the first matchup between the Bills and Finns, they were without Marcell. Rex Ryan's defense was embarrassed. The Bills were worn down and failed to execute their assignments. The number one rule for a defensive lineman is not to get reached. Without Dareus in the lineup at nose tackle, Williams had to occupy that position, which meant that Dusable was often lined up at the three technique. Here he lets Laremy Tunsil reach block him, and it opens up a nice hole for Jay Ajayi. Without Dareus occupying two linemen, they were able to climb to the second level quite often. Listen to what Preston Brown and Marcell Dareus had to say about the game plan this week.
We got to do a better job understanding that our guys are going to set the edge and know that we're not going to give them the edge and let them run around the corner. So we got to man up inside and just make it tough for them to run in there.
I was there on the sideline, and it was one of a painful game for me to watch. But you know, I'm happy to be here this time around. And I'm gonna do the best I can to make my presence noticeable.
Making his presence noticeable should be a little easier, considering that former Pro Bowl center Mike Pouncey will not be commanding that offensive line. Pouncey played a critical role in the last game. He helped on combo blocks and climbed to the second level with ease. With quarterback Ryan Tannehill out and Matt Moore in, the Jets stacked the box to stop Ajayi, and it worked. They did a great job of containing Jay and forced Moore to beat them, which he did.
We're going to go out there and just execute. I feel like we have something pretty good for him, and we'll just play fast and just get after him.
Rex made it sound when we asked him, like, I mean, he wasn't opening up the playbook, but he was saying that that was then, this is now. Maybe we got something a little different this time around.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe. We'll see Saturday.
Something the Bills showed last week versus Cleveland and what the Jets used versus Miami was a 6-2 look. That front will allow Preston and Zach to stay clean, scrape, and fill when needed. Williams isn't the biggest defensive tackle, but he doesn't lose ground versus double teams because he knows how to anchor down. He and Dareus occupy the double teams, which allows the other defensive linemen one-on-ones and linebackers to be clean most of the day. If the Bills want to contain Jay Ajayi and exact revenge for their injured teammate Aaron Williams, Marcell Dareus and Kyle Williams will have to dominate physically up front.
Here's what I know, that when I wake up in the morning, whether it's now in December or whether it's March, I work myself to win, you know, and I get ready. And when I come in September, October training camp, I'm going to work as hard as I possibly can. You know, we talked about earlier this year, you never know when it's going to happen. We talked about, pounding the rock, just continuing to work no matter the circumstances. And that's what we're going to do.